Yo, what is up, guys? So I have the new Clock Dragon deck in action, of course, with some Cyberse, because that's kind of what supports the deck, of course, of summoning the card in the first place. But when you combo it with a Magician card that works really well in this whole, like, Cyberse Link deck anyways, it actually kind of creates a lockdown, and that lockdown is specifically going to make it so your opponent cannot target and cannot battle your monsters. So pretty much, they can't attack you, and they also can't target your monsters, which basically creates a lockdown, with exception of a lot of obscure cards. Obviously, Kaijus can kind of disrupt it, but Kaijus, they get rid of a lot of lockdowns. But pretty much, yeah, you're going to be able to lock your opponent out of attacking or targeting your monsters. And the three cards we're going to be going for are actually going to be Cyberse Clock Dragon, Honeybot, and Cyberse Magician. So those are the three key combo pieces to this kind of setup here. And it seems like it's pretty consistent. Shoutouts to Paper Planes for showing me these plays over here. But yeah, the new Cyberse Clock Dragon. So when it's summoned, you actually send cards from the top of your deck to the graveyard equal to combined link ratings of the materials used for its fusion summon. And then until the next turn, other monsters you control cannot attack, and gains 1,000 attack for each card sent to the graveyard by this effect, which can allow one shots. You guys are going to see something pretty cool here in just a second. But basically, the other effect that we actually want with the Cyberse Clock Dragon is while you control a link monster, your opponent cannot target monsters you control for attacks except for this one. And then also, your opponent cannot target monsters you control with card effects except for this one. So they have to target this one for anything. And then on top of that, Honeybot makes it so they can't target anyways. And then Cyberse Magician also has the effect of... We're gonna skip the other effect for now. But basically, they have to attack Cyberse Magician. So when you have two of these where, like, you have to attack this, they actually can't do anything. This is the next one I want to showcase off. I know you... First, you guys are going to be saying, dude, it's first Blackwings. Dude, no. Watch what this Blackwing player pulls off. And then watch Paper Planes straight savage comeback against this guy. I'm not going to spoil it. It's good. All right, that's all I'm going to say. But I don't know Cyberse that much. But Cyberse Witch is pretty insane. Her ability, I mean, once you just go for Link Summon, you get to banish any spell from your graveyard to add a Cyberse Ritual monster and a Cynet Ritual. So that basically means free Cyberse Magician, which is, of course, one of your combo pieces. Now, in this case, we're not going to be going for the Clock Dragon just yet. But anyways, like I said, Honeybot makes it so they can't target it, and then they have to attack this. But the Blackwing player is actually going to wombo combo him pretty hard right here. And I was like, dude, there's no way he comes back from this. I was like, well, at first I was going to say Paper Planes. Why are you sending me replays of a new deck that's losing? That's not generally what I like to cover. I want to show what the deck can do. But my boy delivered. All right. So anyways, we got Nothong getting an additional summon. Burning for 400. I don't know. He's cosplaying as Trickstars over here. But we got the full Armor Master. Then we got Armor Master and Obsidian Hawkjoe and Apprentice Witchling. Everything has zero attack, but it's actually going to gain some small attack over here. It actually can't be destroyed by battle. And then, anyways, he's going to go finally get rid of the Transcode Talker over here. And he's going to take a bunch of damage, take some small extra damage over there. But we got Transcode Talker coming up back into the game. It gets negated, but we have, of course, card to banish some of them Cynet tokens. And then Clock Wyvern, which is also a new card. It gives you just a free token. We're going to go ahead and make Clock Spratoi over here. And his effect is once Link Summon, you can add a Cynet Fusion from your deck to your hand. And then we're going to go ahead and see the Cyberse Clock Magician once it finally gets summoned over there. 7,000 attack. That was dirty. I mean, this guy was probably like, dude, how did he even come back? That's what I'm wondering, dude. That made Cyberse Clock Magician, Dragon Magician deck. You made it look amazing. All right, but we got one more play over here before I give you guys the deck profile. Now, obviously, you know, the King of the Magicians, all right? Is he a match for the Clock Dragon Magician Cyberse deck? I don't even know what to call this deck. I'm going to call it Clock Dragon Magician Cyberse. Is that, like, a good name? I know, because I feel like that specific key combo is kind of what makes the deck. Because, obviously, you just go into some of your Link monsters. This card, attributing cards, draw cards. Other card gives you some tokens. Balancer Lord, just kind of a stepping stone, I would say, here. But then also, Once it's banished, you get to summon a level 4 lower monster. I mean, he's making this deck actually look good. When I heard about the Clock Tower Cyber stuff, I honestly did not think it was that good. I'm like, dude, it's probably like one of those like anime decks for like younger audiences that are just kind of interested in playing some of their favorite, you know, decks from the show. But it's pretty good. I mean, the one downside with this is he's the only monster that can attack. If he didn't have that, this deck would actually OTK actually super easy. Especially with this like little combo here, because you're basically immune to just most effects here, because again, they can't battle you, and they can't actually target you, so a Borealode was, you know, usually like the card that just gets rid of, like, you know, these boards where it's like, oh, I'm immune to everything. Usually that card wrecks towers. anyways, so he's going to go ahead and attack over. He goes ahead and makes a transcode talk, going to bring back the Honeybot, and at this point, he's basically set up. I mean, his opponent cannot attack him at all. He's making the Dark Magician at the Dragon Knight. He goes to battle phase, but he realizes, again, guys, he can't attack because he has to attack Clockwork Dragon, but then Cyberse Magician all says, you have to attack me, and so the game doesn't know what to do, and, you can't actually attack. Do I remember, was it a Tornado Wall, Legendary Fisherman, old school, like, I think it was that combo, right? Or was it double Legendary Fisherman? Double Solar Flood Dragon, we're going back old school. There's another one of those combos where it's like you have to attack this card or something, and your opponent just, they can't, like, Yu-Gi-Oh! But obviously this is much better than Double Solar Flood Dragon, but of course making some Firewall Dragon over here. Now, I know you guys want the deck profile, so make sure we hit 5,000 like. I'm just kidding. I'm not one of those YouTubers. All right, but smash that like button. But anyways, deck profile here. Shouts again to Paper Planes. It's a really cool deck. Now, I really can't tell you guys too many of the combos other than maybe go back and rewatch the video because I don't really know the ins and outs, but I did see some hype replays, and I know when I saw a good deck, and this one has some potential. And then I was looking over it because when I obviously used the program to copy that, I was like, dude, is this an error? Dude, this guy's a savage. Only one slash draw. I don't know if this guy's a hype beast or what, but throw one slash draw in your deck, that's crazy. All right, anyways, on with the deck profile. All right, so some of these cards, I don't believe I really like went over them, but usually a lot of the cards are stepping stones, and I'll read the effects because, again, I'm not really that familiar with Cybers in general. But anyways, first off, we have D-Grenade Buster. I don't recall seeing him, anyways. So it's special summon by banishing two Cybers monsters from your graveyard. Keep in mind some of them do get bonus effects when they are actually banished. But anyways, you can target one monster your opponent controls with higher attack than this card as a quick effect to banish it until the end phase. You can only use this effect if it once per turn. So getting rid of a monster, obviously pretty good. Again, I feel like this deck has like so much potential to OTK, but Cyber's Clock Dragon unfortunately cannot let any of your other monsters attack. So he's going to be, you know, I would say on average, it's going to be like 4K, but obviously there was a time where he got it to like 7,000, basically one-shotted his opponent there. But anyways, next up we have the Cyberse Yugioh. His effect is control two or more monsters with the same type. You get to go and special summon it. You can only special summon him once per turn this way. And if it's sent to the graveyard as material for a Link summon, you can make all monsters your opponent controls lose 1,000 attack until the end of this turn. I think that's kind of cool. Again, a lot of these cards are just stepping stones for, of course, Link decks, because that's kind of what this deck is. Anyways, next up we have Boot Staggered. So when a Cyberse monster is normal summoned to your field, you can special summon it. I feel like a lot of these cards have that effect, but anyways, when it flicks battle damage, you're going to get a token. More than likely, you're probably not going to go for that effect because you're probably going to want to just go for other Link cards. Next up we have Link Slayer. It's kind of like a Cyber Dragon. If you control no monsters, you can special summon it. And then once per turn, you can target up to two cards. You can target that many Spell and Trap cards on the field and, oh, discard two cards, which can actually still be good because once you banish some of the cards, you'll get bonus effects. Next up, we have Sim Tablier. So his effect is you can reveal it, target a level 4 Cyberse monster graveyard, and summon this card to a zone the Link monster points to. And if you do, return that target to the hand. Kill these effective once per turn. And then next up we have one of the newer cards, which is Clock Wyvern. So when it's normal or special, you can half this card's attack, and then you get to summon a token. You can only use effective once per turn. So we have two of him. Then we have one Lady Debugger. So this card's normal or special, you get to add level 3 or lower Cyberse monster from your deck to your hand. Then we have three copies of Balancer Lord. So you pay 1,000 life points during your main phase, and then this turn you get to normal summon one Cyberse monster in addition to a normal summon or set, and then if it's banished, you get to special summon at level 4 or lower Cyberse monster. I'm sorry, level 4 or lower monster from your hand. You can only use this effect once per turn. That's where, you know, banishing helps out. Next up, we have two copies of Cyberse Gadget. So when it's normal summon, you can target one level 2 or lower monster in your graveyard, special summon it, but it has its effects negated. And if this card is sent from the field to the graveyard, you can special summon a token. So again, a lot of stuff is all about tokens. We're playing two of him, one Flame Bluffalo. face of a card leaves the field, you can discard a Cyberse monster and then draw two cards. And then you can only use the effect once per turn, but you only play one anyway, so it doesn't really matter. Next up, we have Backup Secretary. Control Cyberse monster, special summon. A lot of them have the effect where you can only special summon like one of these, so it really incorporates like the idea of like playing one of like a lot of them, it seems like. Next up, we have Cyberse Converter, two of him. Fall monster you control are Cyberse, you can special summon it. You can only special summon one of them this way, and then once per turn. And then when this card is normal summon, you can target one face-up monster you control becomes Cyberse type, so that can help out because some stuff requires Cyberse. Next up, we have two copies of Swap Cleric. So if this card is sent to the graveyard as link material, you can have that link monster that used this card as link material lose exactly 500 attack, then draw one card. Another one of those newer cards. And then we have one copies of Static Reviver. So if it's used as material for a link summon, you can target another level 4 lower Cyberse monster graveyard that was used for as material for that link summon to special summon in defense position. You can only use effective once per duel. Then we have another Dot Scrapper, another once per duel, but if it's sent to the graveyard, you can just go and special summon this card, and then you can only use this effect of it once per turn, and only once that turn, and you can only use each effect of it once per duel. Next up, we have Formud Skipper. Actually, this is another new card. I've never seen this card. I don't recall seeing it in the duel, but anyways, during your main phase, you can reveal a link monster in your extra deck, and if you do, the name, type, and attribute of this face-up card in the field becomes treated as a revealed monster's, and also, if used as material for a link summon this turn, this card is sent to the graveyard as material for a link summon, you can add a level 5 or higher Cyberse monster from your deck to your hand. Oh, that's pretty cool. That incorporates a lot of these ones over here. You can only use each effect of it once per turn. And then, of course, we have Cyberse Magician, which, obviously, we kind of went over this effect. As another effect where you get to half all damage that you take, which is actually pretty helpful against certain burn decks. But then, your opponent's monsters, again, they can't attack except for this one. But it has another bonus effect. If this card battles a link monster, it gains 1,000 attack during damage calculation only. And if this card, its owner's possession is, position is destroyed by opponent's card effect, you get to add a Cyberse monster from your deck to your hand. And then we got, of course, Soul Charge, Slash Draw. I mean, that's kind of crazy to run one copy of it, but this guy's a savage, man. Next up, we have two Gold Sarks. We got one Reborn. Because some of the effects do get their effects, but they are, of course, Banished. This, like, Balancer Lord over here, which gives you an additional summon. Then we have two copies of World Legacy Inheritor. So it's just basically, like, just grab a card, use a Stepping Stone. Then we have Signet, of course, your Fusion cards. And then we also have the Signet Ritual for, of course, your Cyberse Magician. And then we have three copies of Designator, and then we have three copies of Signet Backdoor, and then we have Signet Optimized and Recoded Alive. For the extra deck, we've got Cyberse Clock Magician, Firewall Encode Talker, Xcode Talker, Transcode Talker, Shooting Code Talker, Elphase, Honeybot, Code Talker, Flame Administrator, Cyberse Witch, important card, and Clock Sportoi, which you guys saw, Link Disciple, Link Devotee, Link Kariba. A lot of these, of course, were used for Stepping Stone, so of course, go for your triple card combo, which is this, and the Cyberse Magician. Obviously, you make other cards in between. Of course, Cyberse, which give you access to the Magician. But a pretty cool deck, Paper Plans. I like it, man. So shout out to you once again for this really cool deck. But if any of you guys got any other really cool new stuff that just got announced, like, of course, the Cyberse Clock Dragon deck over here. Really, really important card in this deck, especially when, yeah, you're going to be link summoning a lot, so you can pump up this card, get a lot of attack. It's an okay deck, though. It made it look a lot better in the replays than I thought the deck originally was. But let me know, guys, your thoughts on the deck, and like you said, if you guys got any other cool replays, love seeing what you guys in the community send in. Send in a replay file, YRP file to azneyesreplays@gmail.com. But anyways, hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, drop a like on it. And if you're new to the channel, hit the subscribe button to see more new Yu-Gi-Oh! Decks, new Yu-Gi-Oh! Gameplay in action. And I'm signing out.